Fields of sunlit grass. Even with a touch of cold and embrace of the sun, the vista was beautiful, all the more because they shared it as one. The ore had been mined from the rock here, though more primitive, as if by hand.
Oh, interesting. That's it, okay.
They were thankful for the bridge they shared. It was theirs, and no one could take that from them. The branches bent curiously here, forming a loop, with one end pointing back the way they had come.
Got it.
Every scarf, the hope of a new world where they could be together grew.
I missed a few back there, but I'll worry about it later. There's the game's fast travel system.
Miners seem to have been balanced, wanting not to collapse the ground above, but supporting it instead. Old cables disused, the mining forgotten. The platforms looked as if they could move, but hadn't in some time.
Wait a minute. Oh.
Huh?
Oh, that's it.
This was what the forest had been carved up for. Countless mines like this one. They both thought it could never happen to their worlds. Yet they still held on to the staffs, taking comfort in the power provided by the ore.
Oh, wait, in the first... So, wait, are the staffs made out of the ore? Because in the first world, we crushed some ore, but nothing really happened with it. Maybe that was supposed to imply that the ore we fall by the staffs in this one.
More vents pierced the chamber, the jets nearly touching. They felt the power from the staffs, the urge to summon the bridge once more. One vent on, the other off. Yet this imbalance was a strength they soon saw.
Oh, wait, no, that doesn't make any sense. We need to turn off the top vent, not the other vent. How do we do that? That means he has to be up. If he's the one who's up, then only the bomb vent will be working, not the top one. There we go. Nope, wrong way. There we go. Well, we're stuck. Okay. Maybe that's it. That was it, okay. So where's the next one? We're pretty close to the end of this level.
They ventured on, ever further. The mechanisms cast strange shadows in the caves. They thought about how beautiful the world would have been, untouched by such things.
What? Ah, so close. There we go. Can't be her, though. That could be it. Okay, I tried this before. It's too much of an angle to make it work.
They felt a charge in the air. Not unlike the power they felt from their staffs, but alive. It felt angry, and they realized they had felt the same presence before. The dragon before them was caught in the trap, and the object before it. It was as if the food was all the dragon could see. The beast's eyes, like flames, burned through the rock, staring at them, almost failing.
We've seen a dragon a few times before, but
the journey had changed them. The stars above them seemed brighter, full of hope. Whatever lay ahead, they would face it together. The dragon, no longer consumed by hunger, recoiled at the sight of them. Or was it what they carried and took to the sky?
So the dragon has showed up a couple times already, and it just is kind of there. It doesn't really do... It doesn't... Like, we don't really fight it, per se, but we do puzzles in order to get through.